Hi, welcome back to Reading Time with Mrs. Primm. Today we're going to read Voices in the Park. Voices in the Park is a great story. It's really a very short story, but the author tells it four different times in four different voices. And I want you to notice how each voice or each person telling the story, how it changes the story. How, depending on who tells the story, we hear different emotions, we hear different things highlighted. So some things will stay the same in each story, but some things will change. So I want you to be on the lookout for that as we read Voices in the Park by Anthony Brown. First voice. It was time to take Victoria, our pedigree Labrador, and Charles, our son, for a walk. When we arrived at the park, I left Victoria off her leash. Immediately, some scruffy mongrel appeared and started bothering her. I shoot it off, but the horrible thing chased her all over the park. I ordered it to go away, but it took no notice of me whatsoever. Sit, I said to Charles. Here. I was just planning what we should have to eat that evening when I saw Charles had disappeared. Oh dear, where had he gone? You get some frightful types in the park these days. I called his name for what seemed like ages. Then I saw him talking to a very rough-looking child. Charles, come here at once, I said, and come here, please, Victoria. We walked home in silence. Second voice. I needed to get out of the house, so me and Smudge took the dog to the park. He loves it there. I wish I had half the energy he's got. I settled on a bench and looked through the paper for a job. I know it's a waste of time, but you've got to have some hope, haven't you? Then it was time to go. Smudge cheered me up. She chattered happily to me all the way home. Third voice. I was at home on my own again. It's so boring. Then my mother said that it was time for our walk. There was a very friendly dog in the park, and Victoria was having a great time. I wished I was. Do you want to come on the slide? A voice asked. It was a girl, unfortunately, but I went anyway. She was great on the slide. She went really fast. I was amazed. The two dogs raced around like old friends. The girl took off her coat and swung on the climbing bars. So I did the same. I'm good at climbing trees, so I showed her how to do it. She told me her name was Smudge, a funny name, I know, but she's nice. Then my mother caught us talking together, and I had to go home. Maybe Smudge will be there next time. Fourth voice. Dad had really been fed up, so I was happy when he said we could take Albert to the park. Albert's always in such a hurry to be left off his leash. He went straight up to this nice dog and sniffed its backside. He always does that. Of course, the other dog didn't mind, but its owner was really angry, the silly twit. I got talking to this boy. I thought he was kind of a wimp at first, but he's okay. We played on the seesaw, and he didn't say much, but later on, he was more friendly. We both burst out laughing when we saw Albert taking a swim. Then we all played on the bandstand, and I felt really, really happy. Charlie picked a flower and gave it to me. Then his mom called him, and he had to go. He looked sad. When I got home, I put the flower in some water and made Dad a nice cup of cocoa. The end. So, four voices, four different voices. The story is told from the voice of the dad, the voice of the mom, the voice of Charlie, and the voice of Smudge. So think about the things that changed in those stories and think about the facts that stayed the same. It's a really interesting story. I really like it. Voices in the Park by Anthony Brown.